Number 1. Counter punch windows. In Fight Night Champion, when a fighter misses a punch, there's this huge, exaggerated counter punch window. Even when you get to the settings and turn the counter punch window all the way down, it's still enormous. I would hope that ESBC has a much more subtle and realistic counter punching system. The good news is, they said that their counter punch system was in like phase 3 of testing or something like that, which implies that there is a good amount of depth to it. Counter punches should be harder to land, and when they do land, they should be more devastating. And for shit's sake, can you stop shaking the camera? Number 2. Judges actually score the fight right. In Fight Night Champion, it's as if all of the judges sit right together and agree that they don't care about jabs, ring generalship, or intelligent striking. All too often, the fighter who lands a couple of sporadic haymakers will win the round because their strike technically altered the damage meter a bit more. In real life, landing more punches and controlling the ring and landing at a higher percentage will almost always win the round, unless, of course, you get knocked down. But that's not what we're talking about here. One thing Fight Night did include, however, is the possibility of a draw, which we haven't seen in any of the last 4 UFC games. Let's hope ESBC includes that as well. Number 3. Knockdown severity should be based on how hard you get hit. In Fight Night Champion, the first time you get knocked down, it's extremely easy to get up, and each time you get knocked down after, it becomes increasingly harder to get up. I understand why the game did this, but it's entirely unrealistic. How hard it is to get up should correlate with how hard the punch was that hit you. If you get schlacked by Deontay Wilder, it's harder to get up than if it's a flash knockdown from Vasily Lomachenko. Seems logical enough, right? Moving on, number 4. Number 4. Stun states shouldn't grant unlimited stamina. In Fight Night Champion, when you stun somebody, your fighter gets unlimited stamina for a significant period of time. After you whale punches for 15 seconds, once you return to normal, your stamina is unaffected from that burst of energy. That's like the opposite of what happens in real life, as fighters will commonly burn themselves out during a flurry of punches when they're trying to finish their opponent. I think ESBC should include some kind of risk-reward system during stun states, the reward being scoring a knockdown or a knockout, but the risk being, of course, gassing out. The fifth entry on our list is to have different inputs for body and head block. One of the ways that EA Sports simplified their boxing game is by making RT block both head and body strikes. In Fight Night Round 4, in order to block a headshot, you used to have to move up on your analog stick, and to block your body, you had to move down on your analog stick. The Fight Night Champion blocking system is essentially one block fits all, and that's not realistic. Every combat sports game should have a different input for body and head block. Let's move on to the next entry. Number 6. Something to do between rounds. In Fight Night Champion, in between rounds, you just listen to your corner to find out if you won or lost, and then you quickly skip it. Ironically, in previous Fight Night titles, you had this little cut and swelling game, which gave you something to look forward to in between rounds. One thing that I think would be even cooler is if you took the role of the trainer in between rounds and had to decide between dialogue options and maybe get rewarded or punished based on if you chose the right one. Maybe, as the trainer, you can keep an ace up your sleeve and mention the fighter's deep motivation to unlock a few extra stamina points. Based on if you used that motivation at the right or wrong time of the fight, that would dictate if you get those stamina points. In my opinion, this is realistic, because in real life, a trainer will wake their fighter up by reminding them about certain situations in their real life to motivate them, or things like that. Moving on to number 7. Number 7. Different punch animations for each fighter. Now, this may be a little bit of a reach, because keep in mind, this is an indie company, and they likely have a limited budget, and they might not have enough money to do motion capture for all these different athletes. Maybe it's more reasonable to hope that they do motion capture for some or most of the famous ones, and that they build some custom cool animations for different fighters. I don't feel this will make or break the game, because like I said, it's an indie game, and you should have reasonable expectations. However, if they can pull this off, it would be a major feather in their cap. Number 8. The step back counter should be less effective. I don't know about you guys, but it seemed like in Fight Night Champion, you could counter everything with the step back counter. Sometimes you'd find people online who literally refused to initiate the action because the only thing they would do is the step back counter. You guys let me know if you think I'm on point with this assessment or if I'm just a salty bitch from losing too many fights to the step back counter. Number 9, body blows should affect stamina more. If I had a nickel for every time I fought online and absolutely battered the opponent's body, and not only did the judges not even count the body shots, but my opponent doesn't look nearly as tired as they should be. In ESBC, I hope both that the judges weigh the body shots, but also that the body shots do significant damage to your opponent's stamina. I don't know why, but I feel like I'm gonna get eaten alive in the comments for this. Let me know if you agree or disagree. Number 10, punch impact actually counting. In Fight Night Champion, you can land like 100 haymakers to your opponent's face and nothing happens. These fighters are built to absorb way too much damage. One thing that is cool in Fight Night Champion is that you can land flash KOs, but these flash KOs seem to happen so sporadic and randomly with no real rhyme or reason. Additionally, if the fighter is going to eat hundreds of shots, their face should probably wear blood, cuts, and bruises. In Fight Night Champion, they're able to absorb punches while barely bruising, if at all. Let's hope that ESBC includes flash knockouts and realistic blood and cuts. Number 11, the last entry on this list, is feints. Get this, Fight Night Champion is a boxing game, and they didn't include feints. I mean, in boxing, there's literally 4 things you can do. You can block, you can move, you can punch, you can feint. They didn't include the feints, and blocking is extremely oversimplified. Remember, if you want to win a free Xbox Series S, all you gotta do is start commenting on my videos, and you'll have a very good chance to win, like I said at the beginning of this video. I'll even help you get started. If there's anything that I forgot to add to this list, feel free to let me know in the comments, and I'll make an entire list out of your suggestions. If you enjoyed this video, consider checking out my critique of UFC 4. Or maybe you want to see me rebuild Deontay Wilder from the ground up in Fight Night Champion's career mode. If so, click the video at the bottom of your screen. My name is Adam Arcee. You're watching Combat Sports Gaming.